Laura McKenzie.
And I'm Bob Chandler, and today we have some great adventures planned for you.
You know, one thing we found is that adventure is something you can find all over the world, and sometimes you've got to travel the world to find it.
That's right, and as you're about to see, this week's show proves that we as far as Africa and all over North America in search of adventure.
Well, I'm ready to get started, so why don't we hit the road?
Let's go.
You know, sometimes getting off the beaten path is the first step on the road to adventure, especially when the four-wheel drive's involved.
That's right. Four-wheeling in remote backcountry is definitely an adventure, but you better be prepared, as Harvey Shane shows us in this next adventure. Well, there's no question the beauty and challenge of off-roading make it a favorite adventure sport.
As we've learned, having four-wheel drive is only the beginning. Here's Harvey Shane.
What we're going to do is take what's basically a stock Jeep Cherokee, and we're going to modify it for off-roading. And the reason we're going to do this is because what's good for on the road is not necessarily what's good for off the road.
We've contracted Michael Stevens of Golden Desert Mercantile. Mike explains some of the alterations.
Well, Harvey, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start off with the suspension. Mm-hmm. We're going to put a half-inch lift on here. The reason we raise the vehicles is to give it more ground clearance, to lift the body higher off the ground so we can drive over bigger rocks. We're going to start off with a GDM 4000 suspension lift. Well, we put new coil springs, new leaf springs. We have to change the shocks to a longer shock, the GDM 4000 shock. We're going to be putting a 31-inch by 1050 Goodyear mud terrain tire. It's a bigger tire, so it'll allow us to drive over bigger rocks. It'll get better traction. It's not suitable for this type of terrain. We're going to mount those on American Racing wheels, some aluminum wheels, which are a little bit lighter, reduce some of the weight when the car is moving. We've also added a set of rock sliders, which will protect the rocker panels. If the vehicle happens to come off a large rock or a ledge, it'll save the body from getting damaged. In the front, we installed a combo grill guard, brush guard. And the brush guard will keep the brushes from, it'll keep them from hitting the car. And on that, we have mounted a Warren winch, which will allow us to winch out of a situation we might not be able to get through or winch up a hill that we might not be able to make. Also, recover any vehicles that may not make it up a particular hill. Warren Industries also supplied the lights, which will be good for nighttime off-roading.
In addition to beefing up the suspension and frame, one of the most important modifications is in the drivetrain. Michael tells us about it.
Now that we've done the first part of this buildup, we're going to go ahead and take it down to MIT, which is Mechanically Inclined Technicians, which is in El Cajon, California. And they're going to go ahead and install the lower gear ratio, which is going to compensate your tires. And they're also going to install the lock right locker. Without a locker, it wouldn't be possible to get very far down a tough road. When you go off-roading, the result is that when a tire loses traction, all the power that loses traction is transferred into that tire. If you're driving over boulders and the tire happens to go in the air, without a lock right in there, the tire is going to start spinning, the one in the air. So we put the lock right in there, and even though the tire is in the air, it's going to spin the same as the one on the ground.
Last but not least, Bear's collision repair applied touches. Voila! Our American Adventurer four-wheel drive off-road adventure vehicle. I hope it's easier to drive than to say.
Well, we'll find out when Harvey takes the newly adventurized Cherokee out for an off-road test ride right after this commercial break.
For more information on anything you've seen in today's program, write The American Adventurer, P.O. Box 4190, Hollywood, California, 9008. And we'll send you free information on how you can participate in one of these great adventures. Or call 1-800-952-8700. That's 1-800-952-8700.
The American Adventurer will continue after these messages on Prime Network. And now, back to The American Adventurer on Prime Network.
Welcome back.
And now let's return to Harvey Shane, who's discovering the thrill of four-wheeling. When we last left off, our off-road adventure vehicle was finished being modified for some serious four-wheeling, and now Harvey is ready to test it out.
Well, we're ready to go.
There's one more thing, Harvey, before we go off-roading.
One more thing.
We have to air down the tires.
Air down the tires?
Yeah, we're going to let some air out of the tires so the vehicle will ride better off-road.
Aha!
Let's go ahead and do that.
That I didn't know.
Now what we're going to do is go ahead and let these tires down about 15 PSI.
Pounds per square inch.
Mm-hmm. On the normal street, you may ride 32 pounds. We're going to go ahead and air them down so it'll ride better off-road. The tires will shape to the terrain.
So this gives it a smoother ride?
This gives it a smoother ride.
Okay.
All right, we're all done.
After we do this, we can go.
Now, we're all done. We can head out now.
Well, as we head out for a test run, Mike tells me there are some additional things any serious off-roader should have on the trail to ensure safety.
You should bring a fire extinguisher, some tow straps, a first aid kit is good, and it's very important to have a CB in the car.
And of course, for anyone taking up this sport, there are a few tips to remember.
Yeah, you should always wear your seatbelt whenever you're traveling on the highway or off-highway. The best thing to do if you don't know how to go off-roading is to join a club. And usually the guys in the club will give you a helping hand as a beginner. They'll show you what to do and what to bring, and if you ever break, they usually help you out and show you the way of the backcountry. And also, before you go out, you should get a map of the area and get familiar with the area that you're going to be to. You got to stay on all designated trails, and the map you get of the area should let you know what areas are open and what areas are not.
Well, this is my kind of adventure. With a little practice, I'll be ready for the Cherokee Challenge. And we'll be there for that demanding off-road run in an upcoming episode. So stay tuned.
And now, back to the American Adventurer on Prime Network.
You know, we recently had a great introduction to the exciting sport of off-roading, thanks to our own Harvey Shane.
That's right. And as with many who discover how much fun four-wheeling can be, Harvey is now ready to advance to the next challenge this sport has to offer.
When we last visited with Harvey Shane, he was testing out our new American Adventurer off-road vehicle.
And after putting himself and the Jeep through the paces, Harvey is now about to represent us in one of the most adventurous off-road runs we could find.
It's called the Cherokee Challenge, and as the name implies, it's not for the faint of heart. I'll tell you, only the strong survive out here. Now it's time to hit the trail. Michael Stevens of Golden Desert Mercantile runs the challenge.
I started the Cherokee Challenge as a way for Jeep Cherokee owners to get together, go out and have a lot of fun out in the backcountry, and test the different vehicles and see how the different guys have fixed up their own vehicle. We have everything from beginning off-roaders to experienced off-roaders. We have Jeep Cherokee owners from Colorado, all over the nation, that come out to participate in the run. There's a lot of hills, there's big potholes, and there's high chance of doing body damage.
The beginning of the course is deceptively easy. Basically, just a dirt road into the desert. But very soon, we begin to encounter some pretty challenging changes in the grade.
That's unbelievable. Coming up that hill. And then when I got to the top, I didn't know what to do. You know, turn right, turn left. Woo!
Why they call it off-roading. That's exactly why. You got it.
Look out!
As we continue, the trail becomes even steeper and more challenging. You know, we still haven't hit the roughest part yet, but there is a lot of ups and downs over loose and rocks. And the American Adventure vehicle seems to be handling the trail at least as well as the driver. Then about 3 hours into the challenge, a major setback. There's a problem with the transfer case, making it impossible to shift from two-wheel drive into four-wheel drive.
Something wrong with the gear not engaging.
After several unsuccessful attempts at an emergency field repair, the decision is made to leave the vehicle and pick it up at the end of the run.
Well, we're down one Jeep, but I'll tell you, the challenge can...
For me, it means going on as a passenger in another Cherokee. But that doesn't make it any less exciting. As we make our way through a narrow canyon, the vehicles are really put to the test. All the off-road equipment and techniques, four-wheel drive, oversized tires, lockers airing down, it all comes into play here. Even the winch has to be used to get one of the vehicles through a very tough section. A very tough trail. And again, problems.
The sun's going down, and we've just lost a drive shaft. Well, we're still here, and it's getting a lot colder. Well, it's about 10 o'clock.
Full moon is out, still working on that Jeep. But part of this adventure is being prepared for the unexpected.
Being prepared with tools and spare parts was the only thing that got us going again. Finally, we finish up with a spectacular night ride and a safe end to a fantastic adventure.
Well, that's all the time we have for this show.
No, too bad. I was just getting started.
You never stop. We hope you had as much fun as we did, and make sure to join us next time for some more great adventures around the world. I'm Bob Chandler.
And I'm Laura McKenzie. We'll see you next time.
So long.
The American Adventurer has been brought to you in part by Browning, the best there is in sporting arms and archery. Navy Arms Company, first with the finest in quality replica firearms. Winchester, rifles and shotguns, better than Ruger, the trademark of excellence.